as well as the Korean and Formosan Chinese labourers who were part of the Japanese military forces. After interrogation in Brisbane, these prisoners were sent either to the camps at Cowra or Hay. They were a security risk in the Cowra POW camp, and efforts to put them to work were quickly abandoned. The garrison of 300 to 400 men knew that most of the 1,000 or more Japanese prisoners wished to die in battle to erase their shame, and that was a constant threat. Tensions built in the camp. They were held in Compound D, and following their release, it was divided into three separate sections. In 1943, Japanese prisoner Lieutenant Masao Naka carefully made his way towards the camp's perimeter. It was 10 p.m. on a dark April night, and Naka was not challenged, but he climbed through the inner guard fence, picked his way through the entanglement, and climbed over the outer fence. Sometime later, an orderly noticed his empty bed, raised the alarm, and a search was mounted. Naka was recaptured some distance from the town when he flagged down a vehicle in the hope of getting a ride to the coast. Following the breakout, many of the camp's guards spoke about the bravery of the Japanese that night. Although the war ended in August 1945, a shortage of shipping worldwide caused a prolonged period of repatriation for POW. The first Japanese prisoners left Cowra in March 1946, but the Italians had to wait until early 1947. Despite the war ending, the men of the 22nd Garrison remained on duty for a further 2 years